Welcome children to English class. Here I am going to take the last poem of your course Aunt Jennifer's Tigers by Adrian Rich. Let's start. Adrian Rich was an American poet, essayist and feminist. She was called one of the most widely read and influential poets of the second half of the 20th century and was credited with bringing the oppression of women to the forefront of the poetic discourse. She was born on May 16 in the year 1926 in Baltimore, Maryland, United States. She was born to the Jewish Protestant parents. Her father encouraged her to read and write from a very young age and home tutored her. She spent a great deal of her time in her father's library, which was always stocked with the works of the great writers. She worked hard to fulfill her father's wishes, and by the time she was 22, she came out with her first collections of poems, A Change of World. She married Alfred Conrad, an economics professor, and had 3 sons, but their marriage became severely strained because of her being a lesbian. They separated and her husband committed suicide. That's why a large portion of her work portrayed her thoughts about lesbianism and feminist activism. She published 25 volumes of poetry, 3 collections of essays, and more than half a dozen other writings. Her poems and essays were well received and won a series of awards and recognitions from the various quarters. Her collection of poems include The Diamond Cutters, Snapshots of a Daughter-in-Law, 21 Love Poems. Her critically acclaimed essays include The Art of the Possible, Essays and Conversations, and Compulsory Heterosexuality and Lesbian Existence. The poem Aunt Jennifer's Tigers addresses the constraints of a married life a woman experiences. Let's now see the poem. At the introduction about the poem. Here, the poetess talks about a lady whom she addresses as Aunt Jennifer and describes her ordeals in the married life. The protagonist, Aunt Jennifer, represents women of the whole world, particularly the women of the America during the period of 1950s. She represents the kind of women who were caught under the oppressive hand of a patriarchal society. The poetess, through the simple lines of the poem, delineates a woman's struggles with expression and rebellion. The 3 quatrains, that is the 4-line stanza here, expose the desolating effects of the male-dominating world. The first stanza introduces us the dreams of Aunt Jennifer. And the second stanza, we come to know about the reality of Aunt Jennifer's world. And finally, the third stanza is a narrative of the future life of this lady. Let's now know the poem. Now this is the time to know the summary of the poem Aunt Jennifer Tigers. Here, Aunt Jennifer has expressed her suppressed feelings through her art form. She is the victim of the male-dominated society. She has no one in the life to share her mental and physical pains. To express her feelings, she created the image of tigers on the panel of a woolen cloth. Then the poetess has shown the tigers created by this lady in motion. They are moving quickly by raising their front legs and jumping forward on the back legs. In the green forest, they look free, bright, brave, fearless and magnificent. they were least bothering about the men sitting under the tree. But while doing this simple household task, the lady so much shone scared, as she was fearing about her husband's arrival over there. But it's very strange that while doing the simple household task, her fingers were shivering due to the fear of her husband, as she was not free to enjoy the freedom to do anything as per her own choice. That's why it becomes difficult for her to pull the simple needle up and down. Even her wedding ring was the kind of burden for her to wear and remind her about her terrible married life and domination of her. However, in the last stanza, the poetess commented once again that even after death, the lady has to bear the same ordeals and difficulties which she had undergone throughout her life, as her name and soul has to bear the evidence of the same cruel, dominating husband. But the art form which she had would stay forever free, proud and unafraid, just like the tigers of the real forest. See the poem, Aunt Jennifer's Tigers. First stanza. Aunt Jennifer's tigers prance across the stream, bright to pass denizens of a world of green. They don't fear the man beneath the tree, the pace in sleek chivalric certainty. Prance, that means jump over. Screen, that means wall. To pass, this is a transparent yellow precious stone. Denizens, that means dwellers or inhabitants. World of green, that means the green forest. Pace, that means run fast. Sleek, that means shining and well groomed. Otherwise, that means elegant. Certainty, that means confidence. Here the poetess is describing a lady whom she addresses as Aunt Jennifer. She says that Aunt is doing embroidery work on a piece of cloth. It could be some tablecloth or some wall hanging. She has designed on this piece of art with a beautiful image of the elegant tigers, which are running fearlessly in the green forest. She compares the beauty of the tigers by explaining and relating them to the precious yellow stones like topaz. The tigers created by Aunt Jennifer seemed to be so natural and real. They were appearing and shining like bright color golden yellow jewel topaz in the backdrop of the green forest. They seemed to be quite fearless and not scared of the men who were also standing near the tree. Children, as you are well aware about the true nature of the wild animals like tigers, they are always ferocious and violent in nature. So same the lady created on this panel. Her tigers also seem to be very fearless and not scared of the men standing under the tree. So these tigers, they were pacing, that means they were moving about with full grace, elegance and bravery over there on this panel. See the lines once again. Aunt Jennifer's tigers prance across the screen, bright to pass denizens of a world of green. Here the poetess describes that a lady named Aunt Jennifer, she is doing her craft work and creating the image of the wild animals, tigers, on a panel of a cloth. As she was using the silken thread for creating these animals, so they were shining brightly with the yellow stripes like the yellow bright topaz stone. As these animals used to reside only in the green forest, but here the lady created them very beautifully on this piece of cloth. However, looking at this vivid description of the tigers created by Aunt Jennifer here, we conclude that there is a sharp contrast of behavior shown between the tigers and the aunt. Though the tigers designed by aunt are appearing to be quite proud and fearless, but she herself is leading a life that is full of constant fear and oppression. As the life of Aunt Jennifer herself is full of oppression and being captive by the patriarchal society, that's why she had selected an alternative world of freedom with the creation of these tigers. So her tigers represent her dreams and her inner desires to enjoy the freedom in her life. Aunt Jennifer's fingers fluttering through her wool find even the ivory needle hard to pull. The massive weight of uncle's wedding band sits heavily upon Aunt Jennifer's hand. Fluttering, that means shaking. Ivory, that means made of ivory. That means made of the elephant tooth. Pull, that means draw. Massive means heavy. Now here, in the second stanza, the poetess is describing about the fear of Aunt Jennifer for her husband while doing the simple task of doing the embroidery. Her fingers were quivering and shaking due to the fear of her husband. As her husband does not approve of her work of this embroidery, therefore she is trembling while doing this simple task on the piece of her cloth. Due to her fear and the terror for her husband, it becomes difficult even to pull the soft needle from stanza. We notice that the poetess is describing the fear of Aunt Jennifer towards her husband while doing the simple core of making embroidery over the panel of the cloth. Her fingers are quivering, that means shaking, due to the fear of the husband. It seems that her husband never approves or likes the talent of this lady. That's why she is trembling while making the embroidery. Why it become difficult for the lady to pull her needle up and down, though the needle is made up of soft ivory tooth. The next is mentioned that uncle's wedding band seems to be heavier on her hand. It suggests that the lady has faced so much difficulties in her married life that a wedding ring may be reminding her about some of her bitter experiences of her married life. Through the stanza, the poetess wants to convey the fact that a woman throughout her lifetime works to glorify her husband, but she feels so much subjugated that her marital bond becomes a burden on her mind. This is also the reality shown here of Aunt Jennifer's life. She was much tortured and tormented by the cruel and dominating nature of her husband. That's why she undergoes the mental suppression and was unable to do the simple household works. That's why her fingers were fluttering. Even the wedding ring on her hand, it again reminds her of her domestic responsibilities and restrictions which were put on her mind. Hence, these expressions are symbolic of the male authority and power in this world. When aunt is dead, her terrified hands will lie still ringed with ordeals she was mastered by. The tigers on the panel that she made will go on prancing, proud and unafraid. Terrified, that means to get scared. Ordeals, that means difficulties or hard experiences. Ranked, that means surrounded by. Mastered by, that means controlled or put under. In the concluding stanza, the poetess is revealing the bitter truth. She says that even death won't be able to release Aunt Jennifer free from the trauma and the ordeals which she was subjected to in her life. This trauma which she has undergone will linger on. That means no societal setup or custom can stop today even the men from torturing and terrorizing the weaker section, that is women of the world. But on the contrary, her embroidery, her tigers and her all talent will survive forever in this world, whether she would die. And thus her tigers will always jump proudly and fearlessly on this banner as ever. Hence, here we get the glimpse of often said conventional theme that art or the talent of the individual endures beyond the human life. It is eternal. Perhaps the poetess here wants to convey the message to the women of the world. They themselves are creating these tigers, that means men. They need to break their shackles and have to be unafraid like the tigers themselves. One more thing that is inferred from the poem is that Aunt Jennifer, who for the long time has been born to undergo the miseries, now she is also longing for the freedom from the dominance and the male domination. Children, this is the time to know about the literary devices used in this poem. Starting with the imagery, as you know, this is used to create the clear picture of something or some person. Here, the imagery device is used for Aunt Jennifer. She is described as a fear-stricken and subjugated wife. Then, secondly, this device is used for describing the magnificent tigers. The use of words like tiger's prance, bright topaz denizens, and the world of green. So these words are backed by bright, colorful animals, that is the type. After reading such words, people can feel as if they are right there and standing in this peaceful scenario. Further imagery is used in the words like topaz, ivory and the wedding band, and even in the words fingers fluttering of Aunt Jennifer. Next is the use of the metaphor. This is a device that makes the implicit comparison between two things that are unrelated. So here the metaphor is used when the poetess compares the yellow stripes of the tiger to the precious stone like topaz. Next device used here is contrast, that means difference. So the main contrast here is used between the nervous Aunt Jennifer with her confident tigers. Further, there is a use of hyperbole, that means the exaggeration. So here the poetess exaggerates the weight of uncle's wedding ring to make a point about how dominating he is. Next, the use device is paradox, that is the apparent contradiction. When we read the lines like trembling and mastered woman, so these lines creates the free and confident creatures. Next device used here is paradox, that means the apparent contradiction of the thoughts and the feelings. So here the poetess has used the paradox when she says that the trembling and the suppressed woman is creating the free and confident features in her artistic endeavors. Her fluttering fingers were producing something that has certainty, that means confidence. Next, we are going to talk about the tone of the poem. Here the tone appears to be positive and cheerful when the poetess is describing the tigers. But the tone suddenly becomes sad and even creepy at the times when she is describing the life of Aunt Jennifer. Next device used here is repetition. So here you see the word prance is repeated to emphasize the pride and the freedom of the tigers. And the word rings here echoes the wedding band, that means the wedding ring. So this word here comments about the constants laid on Aunt Jennifer. Otherwise, the rhyme pattern used in this work is AA, BB, CC, DD, EE, and FF. So this rigid pattern mirrors the rigid life of Aunt Jennifer. Next here we will talk about the literary devices used in this work. There is a perfect rhyme scheme given in this work. When you read the first two lines, you come to know that every pair of the lines here are rhyming with each other. So see the first two lines. For example, the words at the end of the first line, so they are producing the sound een in the word screen. And in the second lines, ending word green is again creating the similar sound. So these pair lines are rhyming with each other. This creates the lyrical form in this poem. Otherwise, the rhyme pattern used in this work is AA, BB, CC, DD, EE, and FF. So this rigid pattern mirrors the rigid life of Aunt Jennifer. In the last, we will talk about the alliteration device. That means the repetition of the same consonant sounds at the start of the nearby words. So here, when you read the words like fingers fluttering, here fur sound is repeated, and they describe the everyday struggle of Aunt Jennifer's life. Then when we read the words prancing proud, so here the purr sound is repeated, and it emphasizes the feeling of the confidence expressed in the movements of the tigers. I feel you have well understood the explanation and the literary devices used here in this work. I hope you well understood up to this part. Must watch the next part in the coming video. Thank you for watching the video.